So we are now in the sixth week of this semester. As you know, grades and comments come out tomorrow for the mid-quarter, for the third quarter. I mentioned both in the newsletter that's going out this week and to my own advisory that I was going to get together with them to talk a little bit about the rest of this quarter and the semester. So it's a good reminder for all of us, I think, to focus on that topic this week at least. We had a nice weekend, a great concert yesterday. You'll get to hear some music this morning and a lot of successful athletics that we'll report on. We're also pleased with the COVID numbers and situation. Last week we had, I think, 18 positive cases when we started. This week we have 11, and we had about 56 or so, maybe more, closer to 60 people quarantined last week, and we have low 20s this week. So things are, like the city, moving in a direction that we hope will be better for all of us. On that same note, the faculty and staff will know that this week Metro Health is going to roll out a plan to give all of the teachers in both public and private schools the vaccine. And so that should be set by next week for them to receive the vaccine. Of course, this is President's Weekend, and you know the cautionary notes about travel and about gatherings. Just keep the mitigations in place and be careful. A couple of people have asked me to mention that with all of the indoor eating and bags from lunches, please be both thoughtful and responsible about putting things in trash cans, and be the kind of citizen that if you see something on the ground, pick it up, keep things clean. Secondly, I know that it's a bit of a pain to fill out that form each week about lunch, but it is imperative that we all do so that we help the dining hall. If you think it's difficult, imagine how difficult it is for them each week to have to kind of sort through all that information. So please do so, and again, be a good citizen. Last Tuesday, I believe, Ms. Williams met with the sophomore class about SILO and about the sophomore summer service internship. Applications are due this week on Thursday, the 11th. You should have all the details, so this is simply a reminder and to say if you have any questions, please email her. The booth now is going to show us a video of thanks for the funds we raised for News 2 Food to Families.
Congratulations to Montgomery Bell Academy, our top high school in the News 2 Food to Families School Food Drive, benefiting Second Harvest Food Bank of Middle Tennessee.
We at Apex Moving Plus Storage thank you for collecting more than 127,000 food items to help feed hungry families throughout Middle Tennessee.
On behalf of everyone here, Fifth Third Bank would like to present Montgomery Bell Academy with a $1,000 check and celebrate your hard work.
Well, congratulations to you all for helping us do that. I have typically given that money to the service club, and in turn they use that for various projects they have. So it's a nice turnabout of recognizing the school and then being able to be rewarded to help out the service programs. As you know from last week's assembly, we are recognizing Black History Month with some, I think, creative presentations and some great music. And I'm going to let Mr. Calavita behind me introduce today's arrangement from the headmasters.
Good morning, everyone. I just wanted to take a moment to talk about the piece that we're about to perform for you all, because the tradition of the Black spiritual is actually one that has a lot of significance to Nashville. Spirituals were not originally intended as concert fare, but they became so after being popularized as concert pieces by historically Black colleges and universities who would take these pieces on their concert tours throughout America. But did you know that the first group to do so was actually from here in Nashville? It was Fisk University. The Fisk University Jubilee Singers in 1871 had a concert tour. They went across America to raise money for the university, which was financially struggling at the time. And since then, they have performed internationally, and the tradition has blossomed such that these are songs that are sung by choirs across the country and across the world. And I bring up Fisk specifically because I knew when we were preparing a spiritual to celebrate Black History Month that it would be imperative for me to introduce more voices to the conversation and to the preparation of the piece than just my own. And I was very fortunate to welcome to our class over the course of the past week Dr. Paul Kwame, the current director of the Fisk Jubilee Singers. Dr. Kwame is a world expert on this genre of music, and we had a chance to prepare this piece collaboratively with him. I know that my students got a tremendous amount from his teaching, as did I, and we are very excited to present this offering of William Dawson's Sooner Will Be Done.
Sooner will be done with the troubles of the world, going home to live with God. I want to meet my mother. I'm going to live with God. I want to meet my mother. I'm going to live with God. Sooner will be done with the troubles of the world. Going home to live with God. Sooner will be done with the troubles of the world. No more weeping and a wailing. I'm going to live with God. Sooner will be done with the troubles of the world. Going home to live with God. Sooner will be done with the troubles of the world. Sooner will be done with the troubles of the world. Going home to live with God. I want to meet my Jesus. I'm going to live with God. I want to meet my Jesus. I'm going to live with God. I'm going to live with God.
While they were rehearsing, one of the students who's going to perform a little later said they are really good, and you did a great job, and thanks for getting Fisk director out here to work with them, and I appreciate that music as I did yesterday's concert. From last week, you knew that we started presenting some profiles on Alice Randall's book, and this morning we have another one. Adam Garfinkel was going to present this morning, but he's not feeling well, so Andrew Bulgarino is going to pitch in, and he just found out a little while ago, and I know he'll do a great job in spite of the last minute discovery. Andrew also built a website that's on the school website. I think it's under the tearing down the walls section, if I'm correct about that. I hope you'll look at that, because I think that's worth visiting. Please welcome Andrew.
Good morning, everyone. So as Mr. Joyce said, I'm subbing in for Adam Garfinkel, who was quarantined this morning. So today I'm going to talk about Ted Rhodes, who appears in the spring season in Alice Randall's Black Bottom Saints. Next slide, please. So born in Nashville, Tennessee in 1913, Ted came from humble beginnings. Since he was not allowed to play at or even be a member of his local country clubs, Rhodes had no choice but to work as a caddy at Belmead and Richland country clubs to learn golf, but he would also sneak on the course whenever he got the chance. Also during his free time, he would hit balls at Sunset Park in northeast Nashville. He attended and graduated from Pearl Cone High School before serving in the Civilian Conservation Corps. Next slide, please. When World War II hit, he spent some time serving in the Navy. After his tour, though, he continued to pursue his passion for golf. The United States Golf Association did not allow African-American members at the time, so Rhodes played as a part of the United Golfers Association. It wasn't until he was invited to play in the U.S. Open at Riviera County in L.A. when he was finally recognized as the first African-American professional player. He won 150 United Golfers Association tournaments, including the UGA Championship in 1949, 50, 51, and 57. And due to his neat and flashy clothes, he became known by the nickname Rags. Next slide, please. Rhodes is a pioneer of African-American participation in sports, up there with many other greats like Jackie Robinson, who was playing for the Dodgers during most of Rhodes' career. He was not only a fantastic golfer, but he was also an inspiration and a mentor. In the 1960s, he coached many African-American PGA members, including Lee Elder, who became the first African-American to play in the Masters tournament. As Mrs. Alice Randall wrote in her novel, given a fair chance, he'd be acknowledged as the best golfer in the world. Rhodes wanted to give that chance to other players, so he took action. He sued the PGA for his Caucasians-only clause, and in 1961, the PGA desegregated and allowed African-Americans to play. In his honor, the Ted Rhodes Memorial Foundation was created. It provides tournaments for all ages as well as clinics. Also, the foundation supports HBCUs such as Fisk and endows scholarships to their golf teams. Ted Rhodes revolutionized the golf game and helped revolutionize the world, and his sacrifice and leadership for the African American community will be remembered for generations. Thank you.
Thank you, Andrew. Appreciate your making that presentation today. I think a number of you probably been out to the golf course named for him locally, so he's a legend in our own environment nearby. I'd like for Bo Wilbanks and Connor Stenson to come up. They're going to make an announcement about track, and I just want to present the news that I think a number of you know, but not all of you know. Coach Pruitt, after many years, talked to us about stepping down as head track coach. And first and foremost, I want to recognize his leadership with the NBA track program, which has won a number of state championships, has been a traditional competitor, and I know he's been appreciated by the runners and the coaches. So please join me first in recognizing Coach Robert Pruitt. Thank you for doing so, and I hope you'll say something to him personally. And I wanted to announce that we were pleased to name Miss Jan Pippen as the new track coach for NBA, so join me in recognizing Miss Jan Pippen.
Could we roll the video? I think there's a video. Yeah.
Here comes NBA, though, looking for 10 more points. And Montgomery Bell Academy.
That's the way to fight. That's the
way to fight. Here comes Antonio Lay, but it's Curry's race at this point. Final curve. It's Curry, Lovins, and Pharaoh. NBA followed by two by Brentwood Academy. John Curry.
Come on, Curry. Come on, Curry.
One hurdle left to go. Followed now by Shane Farrow of PA, and it is Curry. Curry's off to a good start, so is Shane Farrow in lane number two, but here comes Curry. It's NBA out in front. Curry clean through the hurdles. He'll take it to the line and see how quick he can come home. This is going to be one of the fastest times in Tennessee this year.
Wow.
Montgomery Bell Academy right around 3:20. Oh, it's going to be really close to the top five. Into the final turn as they start to hit the wind. Who wants it? Grimace on their faces, legs pumping. Here comes Ragsdale. It's NBA on the outside. The 100 meter lead is gone, and NBA storms back for a win on the boys 4x800. Oh my goodness.
So as you can see in that video, NBA has historically been one of the best track programs in Tennessee. And I want to tell you my story. So for those of you who don't know me, I'm Bo Wilbanks. I'm a senior here. And I started running track as a freshman. And I had never run track before. I was really slow, and I was mainly focused on football. So I decided to run track to try to improve my speed and skill as a football player. And eventually, I worked hard for 3 years in the track program and got fast enough to the point where I played good minutes for the football team this year. So I'm speaking mainly to those that, you know, are not really thinking about track but have another sport in mind. Track is not just for track. It's for other sports, too, and you can get faster and improve yourself through track. And I highly encourage those of you that are not sure what to do in the spring yet to come out for track and improve your speed and skill as an athlete, and it really helps a lot. And I'll let Connor.
Yeah, so as you all saw in that video, that was the 2019 state championships. We won all four of the relays as well as many other events. So I'm a senior pole vaulter, and as you see, speed and strength come from track. And if you want to get faster, I don't know any sport that doesn't want their athletes to be faster, so come out for track. There's an information meeting in here tomorrow during break. And even if you're in a sport right now and you're planning to do track, please come to that meeting. Thank you.
Thank you, Bo and Connor. So information meeting tomorrow morning about track. I mentioned a lot of athletic events this weekend. The varsity wrestling team competed in the TSSAA state duels. They fell to Christian Brothers 49-20. But they defeated Father Ryan in the third place match, 36-34. They will also compete in the regional individual tournament this Saturday. So please, let's give them a round of applause for having a great team finish this year. Our basketball varsity team defeated Ryan this week. They lost to JP2, and then they came back and defeated Lipscomb. The junior school A team defeated Valor, and the junior school C team had a close loss to Lipscomb. Our swim and dive teams have had competition, so to speak, the last couple of weekends, not against many other schools, but more sort of self-time to continue to qualify a number of people for the state championship in April. And the varsity rifles top squad, led by Max Buenajaro, Jason Robbie and Carter, continued the Plattsburgh Gun Club small board tournament, finishing second again in week five. Another group, our team's top squad of Robbie, Henson, Fletcher, and Carter, went up to St. Louis and lost in a close match. And finally, in terms of sports, I wanted to highlight the hockey team. As most of you know, they are competing for the championship this Wednesday. They hope to win that game and to have clinched the championship. If they do not win it, they'll have a second chance based on their season record. We will also have a watch party here at school Wednesday afternoon at 5:15 in the dining hall. See Mr. Sawyer if you're interested, and let's watch a quick video of hockey. So wish them a lot of luck this Wednesday. They've had a great season. It's been fun to watch them, and they're a great team, and I hope they have a terrific game Wednesday afternoon. All right, lastly, I told you we'd have two music presentations. So Ashton is gonna sing this song, and Sam Banks is going to accompany him on the guitar. Let's welcome both of them to the stage.
Hi, I'm Ashton Terrell. I'll be singing a cover of I'm Not My Hair by NDRE. I chose this song because of like the discrimination that black people face because of the way they look, like their hair, their clothes, their skin, and all that we've been having to go through for like years and years, and that's why I chose this song, and I wrote to it a little bit. Little girl with a pressing curl, Asia, she got a Jericho. 13 and she got a relaxer, she was a source of so much laughter. 15 when it all broke off, 18 when she went all natural. February 2002, whoa, she went and did what she had to do, oh, cause it was time to change her life, to become the woman that she was inside. 97 dreadlocks all gone, she looked in the mirror for the first time and saw it. Hey, I am not my hair, I am not this skin, I am not your expectations, no, no. I am not my hair, I am not this skin, I am the soul that lives within. Good hair, hair means curls and waves. Bad hair means you look like a slave. Or at the turn of the century, it's time for us to redefine who we be. You can shave it off like a South African beauty. Got on like Bob Marley. You can rock it straight like Oprah Winfrey. It's not what's on your head, it's what's underneath. And say, hey, I am not my hair. I am not your skin. I am not your expectation. No, I am not my hair. I am not the skin. I am the soul that lives within. Oh. Does the wear of my clothes make me a better person? Oh. Does the color of my skin make me a better friend? Oh. Does the wear of my head determine my integrity? I am expressing my creativity. Discrimination and police brutality took away this daughter's daddy. She promised God if she was to survive, she would fight every day of her life. Or on national television, her bottle fist is risen, showing out for the BLM movement, singing out to the whole wide world like, hey, I am not my hair. I am not the skin. I am not your expectation. No, I am not my hair. I am not the skin. I am the soul that lives within. I am not my hair. I am not the skin. No, I am not your expectation. No, I am not my hair. I am the soul that lives. I am the soul that lives. So if I want to shave it close or I want to rock like I don't take a bit away from the soul that I got. And if I want to wear it braided all down my back, I don't see nothing wrong with that. Hey, I am not my hair. I am not the skin. I am not your expectations. No. I am not my hair. I am not the skin. I am the soul that lives within.
Thank you, Sam and Ash, very much. Lastly, the senior class will have a breakfast celebrating 100 days until graduation on Monday, February 22nd. And at your class meeting this Wednesday, I'd love to have some of you step up to make a few comments at that breakfast, as well as to do some music. It's been traditionally a really fun celebration of just the senior class. I'm sure we'll do it in here, and look forward to talking with you about that on Wednesday. Thanks very much. Have a great President's Weekend.
Thank you again, Andrew.